Mr. Nineham, very good evening. Thanks for being on RT. Has NATO's decision to prolong its campaign in Libya taken you by surprise?
No, not at all, really. I think it shows two things. First of all, it shows that the project so far, the intervention so far, has been a failure. I mean, clearly, once again, the Western powers felt that they could just move in very quickly and change the situation with a few bombing raids, which they should have learned doesn't work in Afghanistan and Iraq. And secondly, it shows that contrary to the 1973 UN resolution, this is all about regime change. It's not really about a humanitarian effort at all. What they're effectively saying to Gaddafi is, we're going to keep bombing you, keep killing civilians, keep bombing Libyan towns and cities until you go. Well, that's their hope. So really, I mean, and I felt that from the very word go, this was really all about regime change anyway.
But NATO's line, nonetheless, is that it's sending the signals to the Libyans now with this extension that it's on their side with bombs, apparently. Is it the right signal when attempting to instill democracy?
Problem is, again, people should have learned from Afghanistan and from Iraq, you cannot introduce democracy by bombing a country. It really doesn't work. Democracy can only be brought about by the actions of the people in a particular country. And in fact, what's happened, as many of us warned, is I believe that this intervention has actually deepened the civil war. It's not actually helped the movement for democracy. Because I think it's entrenched Gaddafi, because he from the start was saying that the popular movement in the west of the country in the east of the country was a movement that was sponsored by the West, and he used that to bolster his position. Well, that has now come to pass. It is now clearly true that the West is backing one particular side, and so that actually serves the purpose of strengthening his support, making it harder for people to break away sections of the military and other elements of the government away from Gaddafi. So I think what's happened is the war has been lengthened, the war has been deepened, and it's actually Gaddafi's in as strong, if not a stronger, position now than he was when the West first got involved.
And I guess, Chris, following on your train of thought there, you're not going to be surprised by the reports that we've heard this week that UK troops were spotted on the front line with rebels in Misrata. That's way away from that original UN mandate, isn't it?
Well, absolutely, and the government's making the kind of slightly spurious point that these aren't official troops. These are, you know, they have no connection with the kind of Foreign Office or the MOD or whatever. But clearly, you know, they are there. They are fighting, and that means once again that the perception that this is a Western operation to sustain and secure Western control over post-Gaddafi Libya will be reinforced.
But, Chris, you're kind of going to say that because you're an anti-war activist. I must ask you, you know, if NATO wasn't in Libya, Gaddafi maybe would be waging war against his own people. Why aren't you speaking out about that?
Well, Gaddafi is waging war against his own people, and we did speak out against the atrocities that he committed early on in the situation when the popular uprising first happened. But the problem is, we are now in a situation where there is, for the third time in a decade, a massive Western onslaught against a Muslim country, and that changes the whole dynamic of the situation. And that means that, you know, what we're really seeing is a move. This isn't a humanitarian operation. The idea that suddenly the West has been converted towards the side of the Arab people is laughable, when they're still supporting the Bahraini government, the king in Saudi Arabia. They're doing nothing, and they're in fact backing the regime in Yemen. And so on and so forth. This isn't about humanitarianism. This isn't about democracy. This is about the West trying to reassert its control in a situation where they feel as if they're losing it because of the Arab Spring in the whole region, in the Middle East and North Africa. And that reassertion of control is being conducted with the utmost brutality. I mean, we don't know. The Western reporters and the Western governments, they don't count the number of civilian dead, but there must be hundreds and hundreds of civilian dead. There's 300 sorties being flown, bombing sorties being flown every week. NATO themselves said that they've destroyed thousands of targets. There must be huge collateral damage. This is a brutal onslaught against a foreign country, and really, I don't believe it's got anything to do with democratic change whatsoever. It's to do with the reimposition of Western power in the region, and that's why we oppose it.
Anti-war activist Chris Nineham, I'm talking to us from London tonight. Thank you.